Everyone is playing Palworld right now, dude. A million plus concurrent players on Steam. Also, it's on Xbox Game Pass for free. Crossplay's not a thing apparently just yet, but hopefully in the future it will be. Dude, this game has been fun. I have been nonstop playing it. We started a streamer server the day the game launched. Streamer YouTubers. We got a lot of people on it. Wildcat, Terrorizer, Courage, Marcel, or basically I do work, myself. Gosh, who else is here? Speedy and his crew with Deluxe, and I mean, there's so many people on it, and it's been a ton of fun to like interact with everybody and build their bases and see each other's pals. I'm definitely the highest level on the server. I've been playing nonstop. Right now we are level 42, and I'm giving you a video here. The 10 things that you need to know when you're playing Palworld. The biggest tips that you could possibly get starting out and kind of into the mid to late game as well. There is one that I can't really show you too much of yet, but it's definitely the highest echelon of PALS. The best of the best of the best. So, in no particular order, I'm going to try to do this from start to finish, like when you start the game to when you're ending the game. Here you go. Really quick before we get into the tips, if you guys enjoy or this helps you at all, please consider liking and or subscribing. It does help me a lot as a creator, and I do appreciate it a lot. Thank you. That's the sellout. That's the sellout part. We're done. Let's go into it. So as you start the game, you're catching your pals, leveling up a little bit, building your base, right? There are two pals you want to make sure you have. Two. One, for sure, is your first one right here. This is a Vixie. Vixies are caught around the small settlement, all right? Which is over here in this yellowish area. This is the small settlement on the map. It's down here. Vixies, what makes them good, especially early on, a lot of your leveling in the game is done just by catching 10 of each pal. And I'll explain the XP in a little bit and how to level up quickly, right? But the Vixie has an ability that says it digs up random items when assigned to the ranch. So when you're building a ranch in your base and you assign Vixies, they will constantly dig up pal balls for you and arrows and some coins, which is really good. You're going to use a lot of arrows. The crossbow is a super strong weapon that you're going to get relatively early on as well. Bows and crossbows, they're both very good. Crossbow will last you forever. It's always a good weapon because arrows are so easily attainable. The crossbow is just always a good option. And so the arrows and the Vixies hold up from the early game all the way into the late game. I mean, they're always good. Although right now I only have two of them in my base versus early on you could have as many as you want, really. And you probably want a lot of them because you're going to be throwing a ton of pow balls. I mean, these things dig up so many, it's crazy. You should, a never-ending supply, really, pretty much. The second most useful mon or pal you want to go with is your Nightwing. Why is Nightwing good? Nightwing is good because if you look at your technology tree here, it is the first pal that you can fly with at level 15. And flying makes a huge difference. Huge. So Nightwing is super clutch. You definitely want to have a Nightwing. You don't need it right away. You can get it at like level 14 or 15 because you can't make the saddle until level 15, but super, super helpful. Besides that, obviously you're going to be looking for mons that are pretty good at specializing in things that you need, whether it might be growing stuff around your base, or it might be cooking things, or it might be building things, or it might be mining and woodcutting. You know, it's just up to you in that one. But you can find a lot of ones like the monkey, who's kind of like a jack of all trades. He does everything. The second major tip you need to know while playing Palworld is base building. You need to consistently upgrade your base. If you upgrade your base, it'll allow you to have more pals in it to help increase your production, whether it is crafting things or farming for food or mining or woodcutting, whatever it might be. You definitely want to have as many pals as you can, which is 15 typically, at least for this server. You probably could increase it on other servers if you have a modded server of some sort. But one of the biggest parts, one of the most insane things is the berry farm. Farming berries has helped us from level 5 all the way up until level 42. You just have these berry farms set up. You have a bunch of mons set to water and constantly farm them, and then they put them into the basket. We have a insane amount of berries, and I will explain. The berries are not just good for the pals, they're good for you as well, right? They're down here, they constantly go into the party, and they're constantly eating them yourselves. This level of berry farm feeds every base. And yes, you have multiple bases, which is why that's super, super important. I'll explain more about that in a little bit, because the base building, just focus on the early stuff, the level 1 base. This is what you want, your main base, your main home. Now, the reason I'm not going to go over multiple bases yet is because of the next major tip you're going to need to know while playing the game. How do you level up? What is the best way to level up? It's really simple. It actually is. You use those PAL balls you're getting from Vixies, and you constantly just spam every PAL you see till you catch 10. That's the first way. That will get you a lot of XP, and that XP scales consistently with your level. So, for example, even at my level, I haven't caught everything. You can kill things, okay? So, for example, here's a mouse, Chris. I haven't caught all these yet. If I kill one, I'll probably get 300 XP, maybe. 500, actually, for myself and this character. Now, I'm going to kill another one really quick because I only want to focus on one if I have to. But I'm going to explain this here. All right. So, I haven't caught 10 Mao Chris before. So we're going to catch one of these. Now I'm going to get off my mount because it's pretty weak. It's actually on fire. What are the odds? 35. It'll go up a little bit. 50-ish. Sure, I'm going to throw a red ball for it. Got out. Unfortunate. Also, I should tell you that if a PAL is burning or stunned or gripped by vines, it increases your odds to catch it. So catching that gave me 10,000. 400 XP. If you see on the bottom right there under my camera, I have 4 left to catch out of the 10 for the Crists. So it's important to keep track of that. You can also always go check your PAL deck here. And like you can see, capture bonus, 11 of 10. I've caught that many. Where if I go down to, like, I don't know, one of these gob things here, gob fins. Where did that go? Oh, even a Jolthog Crist. I've only got 1 of 10, you know? So if I can find low-level ones of these, it's really great because I can throw PAL balls at them, just spam them. But otherwise, I have to use higher-tier balls at this point because I've caught most of the lower-end PALs around. Additionally, on top of that, you can also do dungeons and raids. Killing what they call alpha PALs gives you a pretty good bonus XP, although the actual raid itself is much better than a regular dungeon, I'm pretty sure. So on the maps, you're going to see these little icons that show you an actual PAL, their level, and their name or the type that they are. This is a Demud. So this is a Demud boss here. The Perpetual Procrastinator Demud. So if I kill this, it will get me a bit more XP than killing a regular Demud. I got 660 for it. Which isn't a whole lot, but it's a much lower level. It's level 12. So killing a level 33 was actually equivalent to killing a level 12 boss. Although this area is a bit cold for me. It's a bit north. So that is a good way to also level up. Now, while you level up, you're going to collect technology points, and you can use those to create egg incubators, but you can also use it to create the PAL condenser. Now, what is the PAL condenser? You should never sell your PALs. Never. Even if they're worth like a few thousand coins, it's not worth it. I have plenty of coins. It's not even hard to get them. It's actually super easy. I've never sold a single PAL. All right. Now, what does this do? This essentially lets you combine PALs. If you have a very good one, you can then upgrade one to even better. So for example, let's say I wanted to upgrade. I can just pick one to upgrade, honestly. Do I have a good one here? Let me see. All right, for this example. So we have a Sparkit here. Not a very good PAL, but since I have enough of them, I'll use it as an example. It has Swift on it. So Swift is an ability that lets him move faster, 30% faster, actually. Makes it so he can work much quicker if he runs around a base. You know, he's overall more efficient because of it. So if I wanted to use him because he's overall faster, what I can do is I can put him up here in the PAL condensation, and then I can click 4 ones that are bad. Like this guy has passive skill, Gluttony. Passive skills are very important in this game, and I'll explain why again in a little bit, because it starts off very simple. You don't need to know this stuff early on. It's just kind of use whatever you get. But as you get more and more PALs, you want to be more optimal. These are all downsides, right? And it's very simple. You can look at them. It says red. It's bad, right? So we can sacrifice 4 of them and power this one up to a 1-star Sparkit. And this will increase his max HP, his attack, and his defense. And the big one is it upgrades his ability to level 2. Now, his ability isn't that useful. But for example, I upgraded one of my Vixies who constantly digs in the base for my PAL balls. Well, upgrading her ability level 2 is much better. And even on top of that, it wasn't just like a regular Vixie. These were workaholic Vixies. So their sanity drops much slower. They can work consistently without ever taking breaks. If you have a Mon or a PAL that has their sanity drop quickly, they're a pain in the ass. You have to constantly baby them and, You have to give them medicine all the time, and it's annoying. It's annoying. So having those is really, really helpful. You never want to sell your PALS. Always use the condenser. Always. All that stuff beforehand pretty much covers you up until level 15. You get your flying mount, you have your base built, you have your food source. If you're wondering where you get the berries, by the way, or the berry seeds, you can buy them from a merchant, or you can just find berry bushes in the starting area. We were not in the starting area to begin with, so it was actually kind of hard for us to find the seeds, but it's not that difficult. It isn't for most people. But you're level 15 now. What do you do? Level 15, I believe, is when you get your second base. As long as you've been upgrading your base, you've been playing the game, you get your second base. What should your second base be? It's simple. You need a mining base. Ore is always a problem in this game. Constantly. One of the best places I've found is over here in this little red line area. I'm not sure what it is. There's a fast travel point here called Desolate Church. I'll just show it here so you can see what I won't go to my base I set up. I set up a base basically right next to the church. And that's because there's five ore rocks right behind it. And all these mons do, all these pals do, is constantly mine these rocks. And then I have five or six pals here as well that are delivery pals. And all they do is pick up the ore and take it to the only chest available in the area, which is right here. And so they constantly deliver ore in here. Additionally, I needed some cloth, so I added a sheep in here. So they pick up the cloth and constantly deliver the sheep. These pals are really annoying. They constantly get upset and unhappy with their working conditions. So I built them a few spas. I don't know if this actually fixes it, but I think it does. The next huge tip for this game is that you can catch humans. That might seem like a meme and people are like, whoa, what the heck? It's so funny. It's actually crazy helpful. Crazy helpful. For a few reasons. I'm going to show you here. Here's one example. One of my travel guys is weakened. He's hurt. I have to fix him. He needs medicine. It's constantly annoying to make medicine. Not to mention, I only have that built at one base. So what can I do? Well, I have two wandering merchants with me. And one of them sells medicine. So if I go to this guy and talk to this guy. Buy. This guy does not buy. They're not selling. It's this one then. The higher level one. Talk to him. I need something that fixes weakened. Effective against treating weakened and depressed. Buy one. Done. You're able to heal your guy at your base. No issues without any problems there. Now I can just put these guys back in. Find the one that's weakened, which is this one. I'll trade him for one at my party. And then we will fix him. 3,000 coins might seem like a lot, but it's not. I mean, I've showed you, you will get so many coins so fast if you want. Additionally, you can always have a merchant at your base that you want to take out and sell stuff to. So like if you go on raids or dungeons and you get sellable items, like for example, these precious entrails or all these precious pelts, you can take one of these guys out, talk to him. Well, I picked up one mon, I'm sorry. Talk to him. Sell. Sell all your stuff. 12,000. Done. You don't have to go to a village or anything. So it is extremely clutch to be able to get these guys. I don't know if their stock changes once you catch them. It hasn't yet, but it's only been like a day and a half since I've had them. Additionally, there's also a black market guy you can catch, I'm pretty sure, too. I don't have that guy. He's level 40. He's a bit higher. He's way harder to catch. Humans in general are much harder to catch than pals. Just a heads up. But they are very, very helpful. Wah. Oh my god. Okay. Well, you know, blooper. So speaking of capturing merchants, usually you have to weaken them. Alright, but if you weaken one, let's say I bring this over here and I weaken it, you're gonna get in trouble by the guards. Alright, these guys are hard to catch. I'll have a low percent to catch them, I'm gonna try anyway here. I'm gonna go for them, I'm gonna get them no matter what. I'll use whatever balls I need to. Oh my god. Okay, well now I'm wanted for assault. I guess not kidnapping, just assault. These guys, that's a big egg. You can get followed around forever sometimes. They just do not stop. I'm gonna grab this large egg while I'm here. It's a huge egg? No, just a large. I'll still take it. You can run away from them forever. I mean, like, you know, I can bring out my flying mount. I can fly away. If the wanted thing does not go away, because sometimes they just follow you forever, the easiest way to get it off is just log out. Like, the guard is just following me. If I kill him, it won't matter. It will not matter. So what we're going to do is we're just going to log out. You know, like I said, there's some bugs. But now the wanted thing is gone, and you don't have the guy following you around. You also get wanted if you go to the other islands over here, these nature reserves, and catch the super rare guys there. They don't like you. So that also fixes that wanted problem if you get it down there too. Now this next tip is a big one. Most people are not using this information. It's crazy. Schematics are insane in this game. Insane, okay? Not only does a schematic give you information on how to craft a higher tier version of something in the game, you don't even have to know how to craft the base version. So for example, the base version of heat-resistant metal armor. I didn't have to spend a point to learn how to do this if I had a schematic to craft a green one or a blue one. I could have just skipped that and saved the point if I wanted to. Although I learned it anyway, whatever. But the point is, you can get much higher tier stuff all the way up into legendary. Although I will also say, a legendary feathered hairband is not as good as a gray metal helm, which is a little weird. So, you know, the difference is it does weigh a lot less. So if you're trying to save on weight, it does weigh a lot less. But either way, the protection is not as good. You'd think a legendary item would be better, but it isn't in that case. So use your schematics. You don't have to learn the things if you don't want to, but use them. At least on the big ones. Like, for example, I know a blue crossbow. A regular crossbow does like 250 damage, 240, something like that. A blue does 406. If I found a legendary one, probably like 500 plus. And you use a crossbow the whole game. It's insane. Schematics are so clutch. You should definitely be using them. Save them, okay? Save them all. I've been putting them all in boxes in case I want to use any of them in the future. So, just keep that in mind. Do not throw them away. Unless it's something you know you're never going to craft, okay? In which case, all right, you can throw it away. The last tip I have for you is Super Pals. Giga Pals, whatever you want to call them at this point. They are artificially engineered PALS. I haven't done this myself yet because this is end game stuff in my opinion. But as you're leveling up, you can learn how to breed PALS, which will give you eggs. Where is it at? The breeding farm, level 19. Now this is decent if you want to get some eggs, but to be fair, you can fly around on a mount and you can collect a bunch of eggs. This was like, I don't know, 20-30 minutes, right? It's very easy to find eggs. But the reason that you can breed Gigapals is you can find, for example, let's say, like my Wixen. My Wixen has a passive skill called Ferocious, which increases her attack by 20%. That is a lot. But there's also, you can have up to 4 passive traits. So you can breed this Wixen with other Wixen that have similar traits that you want, and you can breed only good traits onto a Wixen. So it's essentially like doing, I don't know, EVs in Pokemon, I guess? Like that? IVs? IVs. I forget which one. They're getting backwards all the time. But the point is, you can get very good traits on all of your guys. So Ferocious is a really good one. I don't know if you can get off some of these. Some of these traits are like individual to the legendary. Like Hellboy has a passive trait called Flame Emperor. I don't know if I can get that trait on somebody else. Maybe? I haven't tried. But maybe. The thing is, to breed, you have to have a male and a female. So if this legendary only spawns a male, then obviously I wouldn't be able to pull that off. But the point is, you can get very, very good traits, not only for fighting, but also for working. So like, you could get workaholic on top of artisan. So what does artisan do? Work speed improved by 50%. That's insane. And then you do workaholic, so their sanity drops much slower, so they can work longer and faster than any other pals. And then on top of it, you can combine them with a third one. So like, maybe you can get work slave as well. An additional 30% work speed for minus 30% attack speed. You don't care because they're not an attacker. They're only there to work. You could have super giga pals for attacking or for your regular base. Anyways, that covers the tips. If you have any questions, of course, ask questions in the comments. I will try to respond to as many as I can with helping, or other people will help as well. I've had a lot of fun with the game. The game has been a lot of fun. I'm grinding it. We're going to finish the server, me, Wildcat, Terrorizer, the Hot Boys, and thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, please consider liking and subscribing. It does help me a lot. And yeah, thanks again.